In this illustration, we intend to simulate the process of sheet hydroforming in the Abaqus software. In this question, we use the hydroforming process twice to achieve the desired shape of the sheet. This question will be done in 6 steps, and during the step 1, the fluid pressure is applied to the top section of the sheet, causing that to be deformed. And here, in these pictures, you can observe deformation of the sheet caused by hydroforming process. In the step 2, the fluid pressure is gradually removed so that the spring back process can be implemented. The step 3 is an annealing step, and during this process all the stresses and strains will become equal to zero. In the step 4, the die 3 is added to the model. In the step 5, hydroforming process is implemented for the second time, during which the fluid pressure is applied to the bottom of the sheet, causing that to be deformed. In this picture, you can observe the deformation of the sheet at the end of the step 5. In the step 6, the fluid pressure is gradually removed so that the spring back can be implemented. Enter the distance between this point and rotation axis equal to 0.05 meters. Enter the radius of the arc equal to 0.1 meters in this manner, and then click on done. In the next step, I will select plasticity and plastic from mechanical menu. Here, the plasticity properties of steel has been determined in this Excel file, the diagram of which can be observed here. I will select these two columns, copy and paste them. As you observe, the initial yield stress is about 91 megapascal. I will click on OK. Here I'll click on Create Section. Here, time period is equal to 0.001 seconds, and OK. As you observe here, this analysis is composed of 6 steps, and in the step 1, hydroforming process is implemented, in which the fluid pressure is applied to the top section of the sheet, causing that to be deformed. In the step 2, the load applied to the sheet is removed gradually. The step 3 is an annealing step, and as you observe, no time is considered for it and is performed instantly. In the step 4, die 3 moves downwards. In the step 5, hydroforming process is done for the second time, and the fluid pressure is applied to the underneath part of the sheet, causing that to be deformed. And finally, in the step 6, the load is gradually diminished until it gets to zero. I will select surface-to-surface contact and continue. I will select die 1, done, and select the top surface of the die that has been displayed by purple color. I will click on surface, select the sheet, done, select the underneath surface of the sheet that is in yellow and OK. Click on Create Boundary Condition, select Displacement Rotation and continue. I'll select the reference point of die 2. Done. Close all boundary conditions of displacement for it and OK. I will click on Create Boundary Condition again. In the step 1, hydroforming process is implemented. In the step 2, pressure is gradually removed. Step 3 is an anneal step. As you observe here, in annealing step, all the stresses and strains are diminished to zero. In the step 4, die 3 moves downwards. In the step 5, hydroforming process is implemented. And in the step 6, pressure is gradually removed. Here the final shape of the sheet can be observed. I will click on Animate. Here you see the formation of the sheet at the end of the step 1. As you see here, the quantities of stress and strain dropped to zero due to the process of anneal. As you observe here, the center of the sheet has the least thickness. that is equal to 0.86 millimeters. Actually, in this question, hydroforming process has been used twice, once in step 1 and another time during the step 5.